Tonight, from SoFi Stadium in Inglewood, California, it's a special prime time edition of the NFL on EA Sports. It's the Los Angeles Chargers taking on the Buffalo Bills.
From the second largest city in the U.S., Los Angeles, California, we've got football as EA Sports coverage of the NFL is on the air. Straight ahead, we've got a pretty good one on tap here as it'll be the Buffalo Bills taking on the L.A. Chargers. We are just about ready. Cameron Dicker has the honors, and we are underway here at SoFi. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Well, here come the Bills for their first possession, led out by their 27-year-old quarterback in year six. It's Josh Allen.
And in this league, there are many quarterbacks who have their most success running the ball, while there are others who have big arms. There aren't too many guys who can do both. And at the end of many games, this guy leads his team not just in passing, but in rushing as well.
Allen going to look to throw on the first play. And his first pass here is going to fall incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
So now they'll come up on second and 10 once again from the 28. Now a first carry for the brother of Dalvin. It's James Cook. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
And force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Throwing is Allen on third. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. And now that brings up fourth down there, a loss of 6 yards on the sack.
But defensively, you really can't script the start much better. You get a three and out and a sack.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that. They kept him short of a first down on first and second down. And then on third down, they pick up a sack. What tremendous momentum for them to start this game.
On fourth down, here's Sam Martin on to kick it away. And the rookie Darius Davis deep for the Chargers. And he gets it away, and it's a laser headed for the sidelines. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. So here's the Charger offense making their way out. They'll be led out by a fifth-round pick in the 2019 draft out of North Dakota State. It's Easton Stick.
Brandon, I know he isn't at the status of some of the elite names in this league, but I do know he's an absolute fighter because he's heard all the criticisms. He's read the articles that say he isn't good enough to be the starter, and he absolutely does not care. All he wants to do is prove every doubter wrong and show that he belongs in this spot.
stick, looking to throw on first and 10. That's caught by his tight end, Gerald Everett. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Here's a 2nd and 5 now from the 25. They'll look to throw here. On the throw, led him too much that time. It's incomplete.
One thing I have learned, receivers don't mind high throws so much to the sideline, but do that over the middle to them, and not only are the DBs going to throw a little verbal trash their way, when they get back to the huddle, they're going to have a few words to say to their QB, aren't they?
Yeah, hung out to dry a little bit there on the high throw. Luckily, fell incomplete. Out of the gun now on 3rd down. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. It'll be a loss of 2, maybe 3 on the play. And that'll bring up 4th down.
Excuse my snarkiness here, but isn't the idea of completing a pass supposed to mean you get downfield and gain yards?
Especially on 3rd down.
Yeah, that one. How about the defense? Figured that one out in a big way. Yeah, they completed it all right and lost yardage.
Now 4th down, so the Chargers trot out J.K. Scott. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. So here come the Bills out for their 2nd drive. And a 3 and out on that 1st drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out with a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that 1st drive?
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a 2nd opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
1st down, and they're going to throw with Allen. That's caught by Gabriel Davis. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. They went 3 and out on their 1st drive. Things already looking better here, 1st and 10.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Setting up the screen for Cook. Oh, an absolutely filthy juke. He's got some space now. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 16 yards there, and the Bills have a 1st down. Just the 1st quarter, but tackling going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season open opponent. And they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best of them. I tackled him on the 1st pass of the game, and the relief was incredible. Ended up having a pretty decent ball game. But if I had missed him, it would have been
a
long night.
10 more there and another 1st down.
Well, so far, little to no resistance by the defense on this drive alone. 3 passes, 3 completions, 3 1st downs. They're taking it to them, and it's paying off.
So from Charger territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 44-yard line. 1st down, here's the run with Cook. Tackle made by Eric Kendricks.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Ball on the 39, here's the 2nd and 5. Working out of the shotgun, here's Allen. Got a man, that's Trent Sherfield. And he's brought to the ground with another 1st down at the Chargers' 29-yard line. They picked up 5 yards last time, now they double it and get 10 here.
We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
Allen's throw here taken in by Knox.
And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15.
Good work here by the tight end. It's a crossing route off of play action. They're going to let the slot receiver run a post to hopefully let the defense think they're taking a shot. And then they bring the tight end underneath, and it winds up a first down.
We're scoreless after one. The Bills with the football as we start quarter number two, as they've got it with a first and 10. Here's Allen to throw it. He's got this one complete to Sherfield. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
As long as you go through your proper reads and progressions, the drag route can be one of those old reliable plays because usually it's good for a good chunk of yardage, as we just saw there.
And those guys like it, right? They can get the ball with a full head of steam.
Especially against man coverage, because man coverage are typically running away from someone and not...
And this is caught for a Bills touchdown. Gabriel Davis from 4 yards out. And the Bills post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. And down near the goal line here, they're able to throw it in.
And the key word, quick. Quick hitter, out of his hands fast, into the receiver's hands even faster.
And Tyler Bass on for the extra point attempt. And it's 7-0 Buffalo. So an 8-play drive covering 80 yards. And it ends with a touchdown pass to Gabriel Davis. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29.
Nothing free.
The Chargers get set to go here for their second drive. They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down. Come out throwing here to start the drive. And this is incomplete. Very lucky to get that one back. That nearly picked. It's second down now.
Those are the ones you dream of as defenders. I think if he gets eyes on the ball a little bit earlier, he might come away with it. Instead, it's going to wind up as just an incomplete pass.
To throw again on second down. Stick. A little short pass. This is Everett. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Here's Stick on first and 10. That's complete to the tight end, Everett. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and that's going to bring up second down.
The completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
Second down and 3. A give, Eckler running to the right. And he'll take it across midfield and into Buffalo territory. A 3-yard pickup on 2nd and 4. Now they'll need to convert here on 3rd and a little more than a yard.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Third down, they'll throw with Stick. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills 23. But forget the run on 3rd and 1. They shock the D and rip off a pretty big play.
Oh, that was a nice job there. Quarterback and receiver reading the pressure that was brought. They both knew it was going to open up the middle of the field. Nice little shake and bake in the line of scrimmage, got right into his route. And the quarterback hit him in stride, and he was able to run free after the catch.
A shotgun throw for Stick. Throw left side is hauled in by Palmer. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2. 2 minutes on the clock, 2nd quarter, 7-0 ball game. Second and a couple. They'll look to throw. That's again complete to Palmer. And the Chargers are going to be set up with a 1st and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the 1.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, he just did the tip of the ball to cross the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with 1st and goal.
A chance now to get even before the break as they come up 1st and goal. Eckler will score. Touchdown, Chargers.
Sometimes offense can get too cute down near the goal line, but there's nothing fancy about this one. As Coach Lombardi would say, we get a seal here, and we get a seal here, and we run this play in the alley. And that's good work to hit the hole hard and finish in the end zone.
For the extra point, Cameron Dicker. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. So that drive in total, 8 plays. And it's Austin Eckler who finishes things off with a touchdown run. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And from the end zone, Deontay Hardy will bring it out. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Here comes Josh Allen and the Bills' offense back onto the field. The returns on the last drive, pretty good. 7 for 7, touchdown pass. Probably take that, right?
I would say so. I mean, when you're cutting them apart that way, feeling so accurate, so confident going downfield, and then able to culminate by putting it in the end zone, oh, yeah, he's feeling real good right now.
Now he'll try to carry that over to this drive. Throwing on first down is Allen. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
Partner, there's a downside to everything, and the danger of man coverage is if you're locking down your target, you often turn your back to the quarterback and you don't see him. Sometimes you open up a big lane for him to hit you for big yardage, and that was an astute play by him to scramble out, see that lane, and burn them for a first down.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. Allen now on first down.
Quick throw there is incomplete.
Stephon Diggs, his intended receiver. But it's going to be second down. Timeout called for by the offense as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Allen. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. Two yards to go, second down. To the air, Allen. Swinging this out wide here for Cook. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 38-yard line. It's a 10-yard pickup, and that's enough to move the chains.
I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. Here's Allen being chased out left. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. This from 44 yards out, left hash. The kick by Bass is good. And the Bills have taken the lead.
Well, in a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the three.
And they'll be okay with that, but let's throw a little credit to the defense as well. And I'm just glad this doesn't come down to a debate, right? Which side won, partner? Because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put three on the board. Either way you look at it, I think both sides gained something out of that drive.
Maybe time for one play on offense. 7 seconds to go in the half as the kick is away. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. He'll take the knee and the final couple seconds will tick by in this first half. So we've reached halftime with the visiting Bills taking the lead to the locker room. As we'll send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Jonathan Coachman.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everyone, to our brand new studios here in downtown Orlando in the EA Sports Halftime Report.
This one's been as good as advertised. Just a field goal separating these two teams as they've already made their way back out of the locker room. So to bring you the story of the second half, let's get you right back out to Brandon Godden.
Okay, Coach. Yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. A good, tight football game thus far. 10-7 the score as we resume action on EA Sports. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line.
What you doing, dog? What are you doing?
Out comes the Chargers as they'll go on offense now to start this third quarter.
Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well and they've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
Right now, the story of this game continuing to be the defenses, because the offenses, they're finding it difficult to establish any rhythm whatsoever.
I like how you come to us in praise of defense, Brandon, because that's exactly right. That was an incompletion for us there, but we've seen it throughout this game. Both of these defense coordinators, they're a step ahead of their offensive counterparts.
Sticks throw taken in by Palmer. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Up the middle with Eckler. And strong running there as he's across midfield and down to the 49. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
That one definitely helps as they try to push the ball down the field here, trailing early in the third quarter.
And even though they're trailing, not abandoning the running game. People may call it an adjustment. I think it's just much more sticking to what works for you and continuing to have faith in it. And the running game is starting to pay off.
So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 49-yard line. Now stick. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and you have them staring at a third and long, and that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
A good action to this point in the third quarter. Just a three-point game. Second and 10. Here's Stick looking to throw. He'll get this to Eckler. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Here is third and 5. Stick from the gun. And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, the other day they told us when we've got third and 5 or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity miss there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point. And they liked some matchups that they had, thought they could exploit them, unable to do so on that play.
Here's J.K. Scott now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And this one sails out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25, and it will. 24-yard line is where they'll spot it. So here's the Bills offense now. They get ready for their first possession of the second half. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively, just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. Allen, nifty footwork. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16-yard gain.
Give him a little extra credit there. His head was cool as the play broke down. Didn't force a throw, and in the end, got to show off his athleticism with a nice gain to bring up a new set of downs.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Throwing now is Allen. Little pitch and catch to the tight end, Knox. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be second down. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit him, and what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their third corner if he's a bigger guy, and put him on a man-to-man to try and limit his touches. Just keep mixing it up, give him different angles, different looks, like a good boxer does.
And he's got this down to the 35. First target, first catch, and a first down.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 35-yard line. From the gun, it's Allen. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Davis. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Another nice gain, 16 yards there and a first down again.
Well, this is where reading defenses and practice time comes into play. You've got to know what you're running versus zone versus man and how to run the proper route. And they just executed that one pretty well.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Now Allen. Over the middle, complete. It's Cook. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It'll be a gain of 5 at its second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Ball at the 14 for second and 5. Allen now looks to throw. Right back to Cook for another completion. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play. And that's going to make it third down and less than a yard.
It appears they found something that's working, and they keep going back to it. I guess you can actually say he has the hot hands now, doesn't he?
Yeah, well, it's one thing to hit your guy out of the backfield once, hit him a couple times. Yeah, you're right. Maybe they're onto something.
And I think a lot of that is simply if you get it to him in space, more times than not, he's going to get more yardage than you expect out of each play. When you run in the slant, timing is everything. And against that man coverage, there was no space available and incompletion as a result.
Sean McDermott didn't hesitate. They'll go for it on fourth. Running for it. Here's Cook. And he has the first down before he's tackled at the 5. They opt to go for it, and they get it. First and goal after a pickup of 5. So a moment to catch our collective breath after the fourth down conversion. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. To throw, it's Allen. And that is caught. Touchdown, Buffalo. Gabriel Davis with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bills will add to their fourth quarter lead.
But that makes this a two-score ball game. And, you know, the way this thing has been going, Charles, two scores kind of feels like three or four scores.
Yeah, that's a great observation. It's been a heck of a battle, hasn't it? And points have been at a premium throughout this game. So you have to wonder, is this going to be too much for them to overcome?
Tyler Bass now for the point after.
It's good to make it 17-7. That time, a nine-play drive.
And it ends with a touchdown pass to Gabriel Davis. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24.
Woo! Here I come! Here I come!
The Chargers ready to take over. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by two scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical.
Stick looks to throw. Caught by Allen. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
But correct me if I'm wrong, you know, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Running on first down, Eckler. And some nifty running here as he'll take this across midfield and down to the 47. That good for 19 and a first down.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 47. Stick back to pass. Right side, he has Johnston. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
From the 43, here's second and six.
Back to throw. And his throw here is incomplete.
He was looking for the Pro Bowl wideout Keenan Allen there.
And it's third down.
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. On third down, it's Stick. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills' 20-yard line. That third down conversion good for 23.
This defense has certainly had an outstanding second half, haven't they? I know they just gave up a first down there, and for the offense, they're hoping that that's something that they can jumpstart with and maybe start to move the ball a little bit better. But it's been tough sledding for them here the entire second half.
Stick looks to throw it again. Open man is Palmer. And the Chargers are going to have a first and goal as the tackle made at the 10-yard line.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible, hope he's got man-to-man coverage, and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
Here we go, first and goal. Eckler now between the tackles. And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line. Two minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the two-minute warning. They've got it second and goal as they look for a late touchdown. A line of scrimmage once again, the 5, as they get ready for second and goal. They'll set up to throw. And it's incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
Third down and goal coming up here. Stick. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Late game situation, things seem to be unraveling just a little bit, and that's when you start forcing the football, mainly out of necessity. Fortunate that one wound up incomplete, nearly picked off.
So the field goal unit is on the field, as this is a big spot right here. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And his kick is right there. It's good, and they're back within a touchdown. It's 17-10. So you knew one way or another that they needed the two scores. They get the easy one out of the way. Now they'll get the ball back, hopefully.
Yeah, and the question is, how do you accomplish that? Do you onside kick it? Or since you have all three timeouts, do you kick it deep? To me, I'm playing field position. With all three timeouts, I kick it deep and try and pin them back there.
Here's Dicker now as he'll send this one away. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. Well, they can smell victory, partner. They can see it on the horizon, but certainly we're not done yet here. Defense still has three timeouts, and obviously this is a very slim lead they're holding on to.
And let's face it, the easiest way to get this done, challenge your ground game, challenge your offensive line, your tight ends, your receivers, anyone who's going to lay down a block. Don't let there be penetration, because they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and maybe bring extra people to the ball. If you can do that, make them burn their timeouts, run out the clock, life will be good. But if you really want to gamble a little bit, a quick play action, quick throw, might be able to get it done. Just make sure it's not incomplete and stop the clock.
Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up 2nd and 7. He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball.
Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts, and they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. They'll try and wind down some clock. And it's out. He put it on the carpet and picked up by the Chargers. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
I know when you're looking at the scoreboard clock, we're getting near the end of this game. But they were in what was really called four-minute offense. And that's practice, being taking care of the football, taking time off the clock, not giving them a chance to come back. The bottom line is, what did I say in the beginning? Taking care of the football. That didn't happen.
Didn't do it. A costly turnover. And now before the ball changes hands, they're going to take a look at this just to make sure that they have it right. Now the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of the football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
Chargers going to use their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. They'll try the middle with Cook. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Allen to throw. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he will have a Bills first down, and that should be that. 10 yards is the pickup there, and that should just about put a bow on this one. And this defense, they needed that one more stop to have any chance, but that completion, that's likely going to seal their fate.
And you could hear it in your voice, that one more stop.
I feel their pain.
Oh, it was so important. It just didn't get it done. Wow, what a way to finish this one off.
Allen down to a knee, and that should just about do it. Well, you really can't ask for much more than what we just had here. Not only a close game that went down to the wire, Charles, but a clean one, too. No turnovers in this contest.
And I think you're exactly right about that. To me, this is just a pair of offenses trying to find the slightest bit of separation from each other. And they were both hoping that the other side would make the big mistake first. But today, neither side made that mistake. And what we got, a very entertaining game throughout.